Okay, so the groom, Patrick Cooper, has just gone up on the altar. That's what the word was, altar. And this is where we are going to keep recording, I believe. Oh, there they go. The bridesmaids and groomsmen. Okay. Here comes the next two. The first two were the best man and best lady. Here comes the bridesmaids and groomsmen. Gwaylin and Megan. Gosh, I hope you guys can see this. I've never been to a wedding like this before, so this is amazing. Alright, let's see the next people. I'm trying to get this shot as good as I can for you guys who are watching. Alright, let's get the next group. Here they come. There they are. Oh god, this guy's tall. There's Jessica. Three and three. Is that it? I'm pretty sure there's a fourth. Oh, here they come, I think. Nope, that's not it. Is that really it? Should be more. Oh no, there is four, I think. Yeah, there is four. That's right. Now we're just waiting on the bride. Oh no, it's a flower girl. And the ring bearer. Flower girl and the ring bearer. Oh, he can get us as a ring bearer. There she is. There's the flower girl. How adorable is she? And there's the ring bearer. Who's coming next? Is there anyone?
What's the president coming?
Is there anyone? I don't see anyone. Well, there's Nick. All these people. All these people. Here for one thing.
I'm Dan. How you doing?
This guy's Dan.
Yeah.
And this is Dan's wife.
Deborah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Have fun in California.
Thank you. The last wedding I've been to was much faster than this when it came to the bride coming down the aisle. There you go. Well, speaking of drive-thru, there's a car somewhere over there.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise and look behind
you? Oh, she's coming off from a horse, a carriage ride. Oh, this is so much better. Yeah, I cannot get a good shot, but I'm trying. Oh my god, that's amazing. That's beautiful. Majestic, even.
Like Cinderella.
I know.
Wait to the first argument.
Oh wow.
Or I'm working.
So the bride is coming off of this carriage. Wow. I wonder how much this has cost. There she is.
More than we want to spend.
I want to say this is like coming close to 10 grand, maybe?
20.
20?
20. Maybe.
And there goes the carriage way over there. Let's see if I can get a zoom in of the bride. Not sure. Oh! Okay. This isn't them, but... I'm thinking that's, ATN's family.
That's the mama.
Yep, the mom. And there's ATN and her uncle. Okay, there we go. I zoomed in too fast. Here she comes. She's so happy. I'll get a better shot of her face soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Pastor Michael Willis. I'll be conducting the ceremony this evening. It's November the 1st, 2015. I'd like to take a moment to welcome you to the Secret Garden, but also on behalf of Patrick and ATN, we'd like to thank you for attending on their behalf. You're showing your love and your respect for this couple by appearing here tonight and taking the time. You're showing respect, and also as well, it will be etched on the tablets of their hearts that you were here this evening. They will never forget it. So thank you once again for attending. You may be seated. I must ask you this question, sir. Who gives this woman in marriage?
I do.
Tom has brought your bride, sir. She has arrived. If you would, please shake his hand. Uncle Tom, don't let go. It's your last chance. Tell him whatever you'd like. If you would, sir, kiss her on the cheek. And place her hand in his. Thank you, Uncle Tom.
Thank you, Uncle Tom. Okay, this is the perfect time to get...
Whenever I marry a couple, I like to know what happened. I take some time with them to find out exactly what happened. Because love is something that many of us experience in our lifetime. It's special.
Hey, get out of the shot.
And when it happens,
thank you.
It's always different. But it changes your entire being. It changes who you are. It takes your selfishness away and causes you to concentrate on the person that you fall in love with. For us men, generally it's too late when we realize that we're in love.
Get a good shot of the tux and the wedding dress.
And this is what happened to Patrick and ATN. They met long ago when they were juniors in high school. A fellow by the name of Mike introduced them. He could not be here this evening. They were friends for quite some time, but on their first date, Patrick had a 2-for-1 coupon at Panda Express. And so he took her to Panda Express
So that's what happened.
Movie 300. I would imagine he held her hand there, but we'll find out. As their relationship progressed, he found a way to propose to her like none other I've ever heard. He took her to the Cirque du Soleil for the show called Cop. He said he needed to go and secure some drinks for the two of them. While he was gone, the performers began speaking to ATM. They began speaking about visions of her future to her. When Patrick returned with the drinks, they took them both up to center stage. At that time, Patrick got down on one knee and he asked ATM, "Will you marry me?" Obviously, she said yes. Patrick brought us here this evening. Mm-hmm. And so when I asked Patrick about you, ATM, he had some things to say. He said this, that at first sight, the first thing he thought was, "She's so gorgeous." And he looked at your wonderful lips, and he said, "I wonder what would that be like to kiss her lips." They were friends at first, and it blossomed into a relationship. ATM, he admires the way you are, the calmness, and your ability to remain optimistic, no matter what, with compassion and sincerity to other people. When I asked him why he wanted to marry you, he said this, "There are too many reasons to waste." He said, "Pastor Mike, I just love her. I can't count the ways. She has made me a better man, and I cannot imagine my life without her. I love her very much." Now, Patrick, when I asked her about you, sir, she said at first sight, she admired your extremely beautiful hair. She said when she first met you, she sort of felt like you were keeping to yourself and possibly brooding somewhere. But she said this, that once she got to know you, that you speak clearly and openly with confidence in your words. She also said this, Patrick, that you laugh at the same things she does. And he understands my wit, she said this. Now, she also said this, Patrick, she cannot imagine life without you. You become a part of her. And so without you, life would be unbearable. That's their story, briefly. When we've been together for a while, something new happens at the altar, because before family and friends restate words, we make a covenant that was not made before this evening. And so, although you've been together, something new and special and beautiful is about to happen. But before we proceed, I must make sure you understand what you're doing. And so let me charge you both to remember that your future happiness is to be found in mutual consideration, patience, kindness, confidence, and affection. Patrick, sir, will you love ATM as yourself? Provide tender leadership and protect her from danger, sir?
Yes.
ATM, will you treat Patrick with respect? Will you love and support him and create a healthy and happy life? Mm-hmm. It is the duty of each of you to find the greatest joy in the company of the other. And so let me remind you to remember that in both interest and affection, you are to be one and undivided. Do you agree, Patrick?
I do.
ATM? Perfect. We can continue. You would pass your beautiful bouquet to this young lady. Patrick, as you take both of her hands, I'm asking you, sir, to look into her beautiful eyes and repeat these words from the bottom of your heart.
I take you, ATM, to be my best friend, my faithful friend, my true love, my one true love. I promise to be your friend. At times I'm mad,
handsome man with a beautiful heart. And repeat these words from the bottom of your heart.
She's so happy, she's in tears. This almost has me in tears.
Can you hear him, sir? Patrick, ATM, you have just exchanged words. You've made a covenant with each other through those words and everyone has. You've made promises to each other that cannot be taken. These rings represent a circle of life. It's not a broken circle. It's something to remind us as we reverence in the future that this covenant we're making today is heaven. Also, it's made of precious metals and stones. The precious metals are made through fire. All the impurities are taken out through the fire. And the stones through pressure. I'll tell you this, as you wear these, you will go through pressure. You will go through the fire. And these rings are to remind you of this moment. Never forget how you love each other this way. And now, sir, as you take her ring, begin to place it on her finger. Repeat after me.
18. I give you all that I am, all that I will become. Please take this ring. Repeat my promise of faith, patience, and love for all of you.
Now, Patrick wanted to kiss your hand. He said you're beautiful, but in the future, he informed me that there will be times that there won't be words to describe his love for you. And so, in an absence of words, he will kiss your hand as a secret language between the two of you. Saying without one word, I love you, ATM. And I always will. Do it again, Patrick. It's very romantic. ATM, would you place it on this? And please repeat that to me.
Patrick, I give you all that I am.
If you would, Patrick, bring your bride back to this box.
There's a box right there.
The box contains a bottle of wine. It contains also letters they've written to each other that are sealed. The letter describes the admiration that they have toward each other, and also the letters are sealed that they may not be seen by any other person. I recommend, Patrick and ATN, that you keep the box in a place of honor in your home. Display it in your home as a constant reminder of your commitment to each other this evening. Should you ever find your marriage enduring insurmountable hardships, you are, as a couple, to open this box, to sit and drink the wine together, and then privately read the letters of your love to each other that you wrote this very day. As you read these letters, reflect on this moment and the reasons you fell in love and chose to marry each other this evening. The hope is, however, you'll never have a reason to open this box And if this is the case, you are to open this box to share and enjoy on your fifth wedding anniversary. Now, Patrick, if you would, seal the box. Very good. If you would, sir, bring your bride back to the beginning. I've been married for many, many years, and I have some simple advice for the two of you. And here's what it is. Always forgive. Never let the sun set in your home on unforgiveness. Whether you feel like it or not, forgive each other. Choose this day that no matter what, you will forgive each other. I promise you, if you don't feel like it, after you forgive, your heart will soon follow. It works. It will increase your love and respect for each other. And it'll be a great place for him to play video games. Patrick, ATN, today you have openly declared before your family and friends your love and commitment to each other. You have joined your hands, you have spoken your promises, and given rings to each other as a symbol of your lifelong commitment. It is my privilege now to bestow the most honorable title between a man and a woman. I pronounce you husband and wife. Sir, you may kiss your wife.
Beautiful. Congratulations.
Face the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time this November the 1st, 2015, I announce the arrival of a newly married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Patrick Cooper. Congratulations.
Congratulations. And there they go, walking down the aisle, or up the aisle. Oh, there they go as well.
One more time for our newlyweds, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, we would like to invite our bride's family to join us at photography first.
All right.
By our groom's family.
That was it.
The bridal party to follow right after that.
Congratulations, Patrick.
Once again, we'd like to invite our bride's family to join us at photography
in
first.
This next video.
Followed by our groom's family
or
and our
in
bridal
the next
party
video.
Right after that. For the rest of our wedding guests, we invite you to join us under that covered patio where you entered this place. We are
Where's
serving hors d'oeuvres for you.